Thank you for the honor to offer Mass with you this morning here at the Cathedral of St. Agnes. Very grateful to Bishop Barris for the invitation to join with you this day. Especially honored that a childhood friend is with me today, Father John McCartney. We've known each other for many, many years. We never thought we'd be doing this, so here we are. They took him up to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord. Today we celebrate the Feast of the Holy Family. I know these past days, it was a Christmas like no other. We did the best we could to again joyfully celebrate this wonderful season. And now that we're in the octave of Christmas, we rejoice in so many ways about the birth of our Savior. I was told a story once about a small town that decided to put on a nativity play. In this particular year, they asked the children in the grammar school to take the parts. And the one part that no one wanted to play was the innkeeper, the bad guy, the one who would turn away Joseph and Mary. So they practiced, they put on their costumes, and they were going to perform this great play before the whole town. Well, it was time for the innkeeper's line. As Mary came across the stage on her little plastic donkey with wheels being pulled by Joseph, he had his line. "Come on in, there's room for everybody." His teacher went up to him afterwards and said, "How could you say that?" "I couldn't turn them away. The little girl playing Mary is my twin sister, and the little boy playing Joseph is my next door neighbor. How could I turn them away?" Today, we turn to the Holy Family, Jesus, Mary, and Joseph. When I went to high school, the Marist Brothers at St. Mary's High School asked that we write JMJ at the top of our papers, and I've continued that custom to this day for Jesus, Mary, and Joseph. Beloved Archbishop Fulton Sheen would write that on all of his correspondence and all of his papers. And if he watches TV shows on the blackboard before he writes anything, it's JMJ, Jesus, Mary, and Joseph. This Sunday in the octave of Christmas, we turn to the Holy Family, Jesus, Mary, and Joseph. What does the Holy Family teach us? First, put our faith in God. What does the Holy Family show you and I? With God's help and grace, we can meet any challenge that comes our way. And what does the Holy Family tell us? Mary will say in the presence of her grown son at the wedding feast at Cana, "Do whatever he tells you." 25 years of my life was devoted to service as a Navy chaplain, and I'm grateful always for that opportunity to bring the message of the gospel to our sea services. Today I'd like to tell you a story about a ship that served many, many years ago. In fact, over 67 years ago. The name of the ship is the USS Point Cruz, Point of the Cross. It was an aircraft carrier stationed overseas during the Korean War. The ship's crew themselves would endure many crosses in their service. Just like Simeon in today's gospel, we heard the words addressed to our Blessed Mother, "You yourself a sword would pierce." We know Mary's heart would be broken on many occasions, and the same child she held in her arms at his birth, she would hold in her arms after he was taken down from the cross. Each time at sea, you have the opportunity to pray for the crew at night. Just before 10 p.m. at night, the chaplain would address the whole crew, and I would quote Simeon in all of my evening prayers as I'd end them. And I'd modify the words of evening prayer, or night prayer, I should say. "Now, Lord, dismiss your servants. Protect them, Lord, while they are awake. Watch over them as they sleep, that awake this crew may keep watch with Christ, asleep rest in his peace." This Christmas songs we sang this year were so beautiful. They reminded us of the peace of the child born in Bethlehem. We heard the beautiful words, quoting the angels, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will." We need God's peace more than ever in our lives, in our world. And we know true peace only comes through the Christ child. Peace on earth begins with a child. So let me tell you the story again about this ship, USS Point Cruz. A child would change their lives. The war for the crew was ended. They were told that they'd be going home to their home port, but it would not be over until they could do one more mission. One of the sailors found an abandoned child, and the crew would do all to help this little baby boy. A child would totally change the life of this ship, rebuild their morale. They were anxious. They were anxious to go home. They missed their friends who did not survive. They were anxious. We know we are here today because of a child that was born in Bethlehem. His birth totally changed the world and human history. This child that would be found by the crew of the Point Cruise would too change their lives. They would name him Danny. He was half American and half Korean, and he was rejected by the local people. No one wanted this little boy. There was no room in the inn for this innocent child. But what could be done to help him? He would not be found in a stable, but on a U.S. Navy aircraft carrier. The crew acted like St. Joseph, the carpenter. They built a wood crib for him where he could sleep. They made diapers for him, small uniforms, a little sailor's hat. It was said the kid had 1,000 uncles. Jesus, our Savior, is fully God and fully human. He embraces us. He embraces the human race as our Savior. We are part of him, especially through our baptism, members of his holy church, and we can dare call God our Father. The captain of the ship was assisted by the chaplain, Father Riley. The ship's doctor would also be instrumental in helping find a place for Danny. The religious sister who ran the orphanage knew she was up against a lot of challenges with the local authorities, and she did everything she could to help this little boy find a home. Father Riley, just as St. Joseph, had to deal with corrupt authorities to save a child. He had to avoid those who were the Herods of his day. Father Riley would win a passport for little Danny in a poker game. None of the authorities were willing to help, but he knew this one official loved to play poker, and he made a great wager, and if he won, he would win a passport for Danny. Father Riley won the hand. Just as St. Joseph pleaded for a place for Mary to give birth to Jesus, the captain of the ship would plead for a place for little Danny. But the situation was beginning to grow dire. If Danny would not be taken to America, he would be most likely rejected and neglected. The crew searched for parents for Danny, but who would be his adopted father? They knew the Navy doctor on the ship loved this little boy and took care of him and provided great attention. His own wife was not able to have a child of her own, and the crew knew this. But many regulations would complicate him adopting this child. The crew voted on their own, and they decided the doctor would be Danny's adopted father. This would be assigned to the doctor. We know St. Joseph did not fully understand what the birth of Jesus would mean. He had to receive the intervention of an angel to help him understand how Mary could be with child. The greeting that he received was, "Have no fear." We need to hear those words today more than ever. Have no fear in these challenging times of COVID. Emmanuel, God is with you and I, who came among us as a little child. He will continue to help and guide us. Again, things were not working out well for Danny. The crew became pretty down and discouraged. They went to see their chaplain, Father Riley. He said to them, "You give up, and Danny might go back and die." "Don't be mad," he said to them. "Be productive." We too, like the Holy Family, have challenges that we face. We don't give up. We go on knowing, like the Holy Family, God is with us. The Holy Family, we know, had to flee to Egypt. They were refugees, like so many in today's world. They had limited material resources, but God's love and grace would sustain them. God will sustain you and I. In face of challenges, maybe times of discouragement, we cannot give up. We pray each day. We too make sacrifices. We work for peace in our homes, our local community, our nation, around the world. We put our faith in the child who was born in Bethlehem, Christ the Lord. Today's gospel also speaks of a woman of great faith, Anna. In today's gospel, we hear how she pleaded and prayed and longed to see the Messiah. She would meet Jesus and the Holy Family. God listened to her plea. The crew of the Point Cruise also prayed and pleaded, and the captain decided, I have one more thing to do. I'll send a message to the admiral in charge of the Navy, the chief of naval operations, and ask for his intervention. A few days later, they received a reply by message. He opened up the message with great concern. It said to the captain of the Point Cruise, get that baby home, home to America. Do whatever it takes for Christmas. The best blessing for the Navy, Admiral Carney. The Holy Family shows us how we are called to trust in faith. Faith is at the heart of who we are. We gather for this Holy Mass today in faith. We don't gather just by custom or sentimentality, but we gather in faith in a Savior who was born of Mary and protected by Joseph in the Holy Family. They show us to have faith when we can't always find the answers ourselves. God will show us the way. Saint Joseph was guided in this way. May he intercede for us as our universal patron, to always trust in God, to always trust in God's Son. Well, Danny was going home. The vote was finalized. The Navy doctor would adopt him. God chooses you and I too to do special things. He's given each of us a very special calling in life. But as we contemplate and pray the close of this year, is there something that the Lord's calling you and I to do in a special way in the new year? God the Father embraces us with the Holy Family. They are our guide and our example for us and for our families. Well, Danny was sent to America, and before he left, the crew gave him gifts, not gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh, but photographs of themselves, letters to be read one day, a sailor hat. In the years that would follow, there would be reunions of the ship's crew, and the most important invited guest at all the reunions would be Danny, for he had 1,000 uncles. We too bring our gifts before the Holy Family this day, our lives of faith and service to Jesus as members of the family of the church. We place them before the child born in Bethlehem, the Prince of Peace. The crew of Point Cruise knew why they fought a war for the Dannys of the world. The war was not over for them until Danny could go to America. We too are waging a battle today against forms of hatred and hopelessness, all forms of prejudice and discouragement, for those who have lack of faith, for those who choose to reject life, especially the unborn and the unwanted. We are waging a battle for good. We are God's crew, sailing on the bark of St. Peter, united with our Holy Father, Pope Francis, and our Bishop John, in service to God and neighbor. The world needs to hear the message of the Holy Family shouted from our rooftops. Mary, who said yes to God to be the mother of our Savior, show us the way. Saint Joseph, who protected the Holy Family, show us the way. Jesus, who is willing to come into the world as an innocent child born in a manger, show us your way and grant us your peace. Today we honor the Holy Family, so maybe it isn't such a pious practice, but a wonderful practice. JMJ, I encourage us to do that from now on. Jesus, Mary, and Joseph. May we put these letters at the top of all we write and all correspondence to those whom we love, reminding them of the protection of the Holy Family. Blessed Mother Mary and Saint Joseph, pray for us. Jesus, our Savior, we humbly plead to you this day. Bless us, our family, and our church. Fill us with the gifts of the Holy Spirit, and may your favor rest upon us. Amen.